Hello, it's Nitro99 again, and I'll be doing a review on the LEGO Star Wars Venator Class Republic Attack Cruiser. 1,170 pieces. Comes with 5 minifigures, 3 of which are brand new. Well, 2 of them are the same, but they're brand new. And set 8039, which doesn't really matter, and it costs $120. I got mine off Amazon.com for $100. $20 savings, so that's great. And I got this set. I mean, I wanted this set, but you know, there's 2 other expensive Star Wars sets I also want, but I eventually got this one because so many people kept asking me to review it, and I am glad I got this set. Like I said, I wanted it, but it was not high on my list, but I got it anyway. On to the figures. First off, you get a clone pilot. He is also in the V-19 Torrent, the AT-OT and dropship. We get 2 of them, and he's also in the Republic attack shuttle. He's a uncommon figure. Clone gunner, pretty common because you get them in the battle packs. So those figures aren't that special. Here are the new Senate Commandos. Basically a clone body, except painted blue. And you got these new helmets, which are like Spartan helmets almost. Also, for some reason, my clone's heads are different. I don't know. See that guy? He's looking right. And over here, these clones, he's actually looking left. Actually, he's looking right, and the other guy's looking left. I don't know why the heads are a little different. Also, the detail on their their face detail is a little darker on one. So these heads are actually different. Not by much, but they are different. And finally, you get Chancellor Palpatine. Brand new Clone Wars head design. A red robe. 2 small capes. No back printing. Count Dooku hair, except it's blondish. And he does not have a double-sided head or anything. And he also does not come with his lightsaber. I think he really should have. I mean, it would have been a nice exclusive thing. Comes with the Death Star plans. So I think he also could have been hiding his lightsaber. And the only guns you get are these rifles. It does not come with this. And now onto the set. Okay, now to review the set itself. It's pretty big. It's not huge. It's smaller than like the old Death Star, and smaller than the Republic Cruiser and stuff like that. Sticker detail there. These little turrets for play experience. Smaller turrets over here. Lots of red. This is where the hangar is supposed to be, and if it was actual life size, it would be as big as my house, but you know, can't make a Lego that big. Here's the bridge. Like I said, it's supposed to be huge. And awesome feature on this, except for the fact that you can see the clone sitting in here when you take it out, is this handle. Like I said, this is awesome. And I can swing this around like mad, run around the house with it if I wanted, make it pretend battles, which I would have done when I was younger if I had this cool set. But can't do that now. I mean, I wouldn't do it. I actually did do that, but you know, that's me. Anyway, awesome engine detail. I mean, this thing, you can play with this like crazy. It's really easy to play with. And here's a bomb compartment, which I'll show in a minute. And back here, start with the back. Here is an escape pod, which LEGO likes to put in all their big ships for some reason. Sticker there. It just opens up, and you sit the figure inside. It breaks. These break really easily, as you probably know. So, escape pods always break. And here, you take out the cockpit. It's actually a little hard to take out and put in sometimes. But here's the clone pilot. That's a sticker. Nice brand new sticker. It looks really cool. And it's kind of finicky to put back in. But oh, there it works. Good. And oh yeah. You can open up the sides here. Either side. Flip this down. And grab this the gun inside here. And you see that clone with this giant cannon, which in the movies the cannons look like this. There's also flick fire missiles here, these red things. It's kind of hard to flick when you're trying back here, but who cares about that. And a clone gunner. That's pretty much it for right here. Oops. Now onto the front. The front folds up. And inside here is Chancellor Palpatine's desk. Sticker there. Chancellor Palpatine's chair rotates around. The Senate commandos are in there. There is stickers right there. You can't see it. Sorry about that. And over here is the Death Star plans. Here's the sticker. And inside here is a printed piece of the Death Star. And then there's the back of the Death Star. That's a cool piece to have. And now I'm going to show you the bomb feature. Now I'll show you how to work the bombs. You turn this thing here, and it drops out bombs. There's 5 of them. And that's how that works. To reload it, you just flip this up, and you take out this compartment. Like so. And now I shall do a size comparison compared to some other big ships. Okay, size comparison time between Republic Cruiser, Republic Venator class Republic Attack Cruiser, and the Blockade Runner. Stand up. And you can see this ship, of course, is huge. And the Venator is actually about the length of the Blockade Runner. Yep. Of course, this is the biggest ship. But still, pretty cool. It's actually a little bit bigger. It's bigger than I thought it was. And it makes for easy play. Because, like I said, it has the handle. So it's much easier to play with than these other two ships. Even though that has a handle, this one is easier to use. Now, finally, the box. You've probably all seen the box a bazillion times. But, yep, the figures. This set also comes with 2 manuals. If you wanted to know that, it doesn't really matter. There's Palpatine with his Death Star plans. Features this ship. Gun thing coming out. Bomb compartment. Clone loading bombs. This flips open. Handle. The cockpit coming out. It does not show the escape pod, though. Which is strange. Endor. Y-Wing. Separatist shuttle. So, all in all, this is a cool set. I do recommend getting this. It's a good Christmas present. And, yeah, you should... I liked it a lot. I'm glad I got it sooner than later. Anyway, please rate, comment, subscribe. And that's it. Goodbye. Hope you enjoyed this review. And happy Thanksgiving.